Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Starting this video, we have another batch of 60 Starlinks launched with the Starlink 24 mission on Thursday. The booster which launched this mission, B1060, then landed successfully for the seventh time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
And there you can see the first stage Falcon 9.
We are going to take a look at yet another launch coming up soon with the Starlink 25 mission. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, it should lift off on Tuesday, May 4th at 7:01 PM UTC or 3:01 PM EDT. Yesterday, the astronauts of the Crew 1 mission got into their Dragon capsule and undocked from the ISS. They returned early this morning. SpaceX tweeted, after 167 days in space, the longest duration mission for a US spacecraft since the final Skylab mission in 1974, Dragon and the Crew 1 astronauts Mike Hopkins, Victor Glover, Shannon Walker and Suichi Noguchi returned to Earth this morning. Heading over to Boca Chica, here's a view of the Orbital Launch Mount and Integration Tower progress. Some caps for the Orbital Launch Mount pillars were spotted. The orbital tank farm continues to progress with the two ground support equipment tanks. Also progressing is the orbital launch table in the production yard. Work has been going on to repair the landing pad in preparation for SN15. You probably know about the protests from Blue Origin and Dynetics on the HLS contract being awarded to SpaceX. Space Policy Online has posted an article saying NASA has suspended its contract with SpaceX for the landing system to take astronauts down to and back from the lunar surface. Two other competitors for the contract, Blue Origin and Dynetics, have filed protests with the Government Accountability Office, and NASA issued the stop work order until GAO resolves the matter. Raptor serial number 55 was spotted delivered to the yard. A new ground support equipment tank upper bulkhead was sleeved. The ground support equipment tank GSC-3 has now been stacked. There are still pieces of SN11 scattered near the launch site being cleared up. SN15 didn't launch on Thursday because the launch license had not been approved. However, on Thursday, SpaceX did get final approval from the FAA for SN15's launch license. Eric Berger tweeted, the FAA has authorized the next three launches of SpaceX's Starship prototype. The agency approved multiple launches because SpaceX is making few changes to the launch vehicle and relied on the FAA's approved methodology to calculate the risk to the public. In addition to this, he also posted a tweet saying, as a condition of the SpaceX license, an FAA safety inspector is required to be on site in Boca Chica, Texas for all Starship launches. The FAA safety inspector is expected to arrive on site on April 29th to support a possible launch this week. There is a tweet about Starlink authorization for Starship. It says the FCC has just released an experimental authorization to operate a single Starlink terminal in Boca Chica, max altitude 41,000 feet. It will be effective from April 28th to June 28th. There was a closure for Friday where SpaceX looked to be gearing up for a flight before it was cancelled. As of now, no new dates have been added for a possible test flight. Even though there are no road and beach closures, the FAA has posted temporary flight restrictions to their website. There is a TFR for tomorrow, Monday 3rd and Tuesday 4th, so we could see a test flight this coming week, hopefully. Starship SN16 is progressing at pace as it's now fully stacked in the high bay. Starship SN17's nose cone is almost ready inside the tent, with the nose cone barrel section with lead-ins and lots of heat shield tiles outside. As always, thank you to Mary, known as Boca Chica Girl, who's out in Boca Chica all day, every day filming the amazing content. Plus, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working hard behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. Just in case you are unaware, we have a shop with some cool SpaceX themed stickers if you want some, link in the description. We also have a Discord server where you can come and join a bunch of space fans, link to that in the description too. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.